गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन। सो लास्ट क्लास वी हैव डिस्कस रिगार्डिंग दी विवेक ख्याति। देर आर डिफरेंट स्टेजेस ऑफ विवेक ख्याति। देर आर सेवन स्टेजेस वी डिस्कस। तस्य सप्तता प्रांतभूमि प्रज्ञा। तस्य सप्तता प्रांतभूमि प्रज्ञा मीन्स द सप्तभूमि सेवन स्टेजेस ऑफ विवेक ख्याति वी डिस्कस ऑलरेडी। नाउ इन दिस सूत्र विल बी टॉकिंग सम अदर न्यू टेक्निक थ्रू विच वी कैन रीच टू और अटेन टू असंप्रज्ञात समाधि। सो दिस आर द लिंक्स आर द हेल्पफुल टू अटेन the higher goal of yoga, that is samadhi or kaivalyam. Kaivalya stands for asamprajnata samadhi. Okay, like we discussed in the first methods to attain asamprajnata samadhi, that is abhyasa vairagya. Second method is ishvara pranidhana dva. Third method we discussed in second chapter, that is kriya yoga, and this is the fourth method under second chapter, which is yoganga abhyasa. So let's see what is the sutra here. See what he explains here. Yoganga anusthana rasuddhikshaye jnana deeptihi ravyoga khyatehe. I repeat again. Yoganga anusthana rasuddhikshaye jnana deeptihi ravyoga khyatehe. If you split this line, it will become here like yoga anga anusthanat अशुद्धि से ज्ञान दीप्ते ही अव्यवक ख्याते है। ओके, इफ यू सी हियर योग अंग अनुष्ठानात अशुद्धि से ज्ञान दीप्ति ही अव्यवक ख्याते है। इफ यू स्प्रेड दिस इट कम्स, इफ यू स्प्रेड दिस संधि। सो व्हाट इज टेलिंग हियर, योगा अंगस, देयर बी सम अंगस मीन्स लिम्स विल बी देयर। ओके, लिम्स विल बी देयर, द योगा लिम्स। अनुष्ठान मीन्स द बाय प्रैक्टिसिंग। ओके, सो प्रैक्टिसिंग ऑफ लिम्स, योगा लिम्स, व्हाट विल हैपन, अशुद्धि। अशुद्धि मीन्स द इम्प्यूरिटी। ओके, इम्प्यूरिटी व्हिच इज प्रेजेंट इन योर माइंड और चित्त। इन फर्स्ट सूत्र पत्नी योग सूत्र आई डिस्कस रिगार्डिंग द चित्त एंड चित्त भूमिस। देयर यू शुड नो चित्तभूमिस आर फाइव। व्हाट आर द चित्तभूमिस फाइव आर क्षिप्त, मूर, विक्षिप्त, एकाग्र एंड निरुद्ध। देयर आर फाइव भूमिस एंड दिस टू भूमिस कम्स अंडर समाधि। मीन्स एकाग्र इज रिलेटेड टू संप्रज्ञात समाधि, निरुद्ध इज रिलेटेड टू असंप्रज्ञात। दैट यू शुड नो बिकॉज इन संप्रज्ञात स्टेट, इन एकाग्र स्टेट, हेयर विल बी सत्व गुण विल बी मोर एंड हेयर नो गुण। ओके, बियॉन्ड द गुण इट विल बी निर्गुण स्टेट, दैट इज कॉल्ड असंप्रज्ञात। बट द अर्लियस्ट स्टेजेस ऑफ चित्त मीन्स क्षिप्त, मूर, विक्षिप्त, इन दिस लेवल द रजोगुण एंड तमोगुण विल बी प्रीडोमिनेंट। सो टू डिक्रीज, टू क्लीन दिस rajos and tamas in the chitta, we need to go for the yoga anga abhyasa, the practice of yoga angas. Okay. Now already discussed in the first chapter for the practicing methods of what you as practicing methods of abhyasa viragya, and all these methods are for the high level practitioner. High level practitioner in the sense it's called as the bhava pratyaya. Okay, bhava pratyaya for the abhyasa vairagya and all these things. But in this chapter, here ashtanga yoga is explained for the upaya pratyaya. That you should know, bhava pratyaya and upaya pratyaya. Upaya pratyaya means for the general practitioner, for general, for you and me. We have not done any kind of practice, yoga practice in our earlier birth or pre-birth. We are starting now, so we need to go through easy steps, which is called as the upaya pratyaya, general step, that is yoganga abhyasa. So if you practice yoganga abhyasa, what will happen, the ashuddhi which is present, impurities in the level of shipta, mura, vikshipta means rajas and tamas, that will become zero, decrease. They will decrease. Before it is a high state, it will decrease. So So if it is automatic decrease means what will happen? Automatically the sattva guna which is present in the ekagra state that will be influenced. It will increase. So increase means the person can achieve the sampragyata state here in the sampragyata ekagra state. Then only he can do further practice in the level of sampragyata and he reach to the asampragyata state. Who? Here we are talking about the upaya pratyaya or general yoga practitioner. Those who already practice bhava pratyaya. Means here bhava pratyaya means earlier birth they already have gone through all these things. For them these things are not there. They are in this state, sampragyata state. Okay, because shipta mura vikshipta already is not there for in them. Because they already practice yoga pribhat or previous birth. Okay, so they are direct here. And for the normal practitioner, general practitioner, that is called upaya pratyaya, ashtanga yoga is explaining here. This is called the yoga anga or ashtanga yoga. Okay, so this is the one part. So ashuddhiksha, the ashuddhi which is present, impurity which is present inside the chitta. Chitta mainly related to this rajas and tamas. So remember, in the level of sampragyata, sattva-guna is needed. Okay, at the end, if you are full sattva-guna is online there, then at the end you need to leave that guna also. If you present the sattva-guna, that also not guna-atita state, that is related to sampragyata state, not free for fully. But if you want to free fully, that is called asampragyata state, that is no guna, guna-atita state, asampragyata samadhi, that is. Okay, but initially the sattva-guna is needed, initially, good qualities. At the end you should go beyond the qualities, guna-atita state. Okay, so this is the one part here. Let me rub this, otherwise it looks odd. Yes, so we discuss here, up to here, this part we have seen. So here what happened? The impurities will become zero, decrease in the level of Shipta, Mura and Vikshipta, three level. Then what will happen? This is the first benefit of Yoganga. If the question asks in exam, NET exam or any other exam, yoga related, you should give the answer is two. Two benefits are there by practice of Yoganga. What are the first benefit is called Ashuddhi. Here A will be present, here A. Okay, Shandhi is there, Ashuddhi. So here Ashuddhi will become perish, zero. First one. Then next benefit is Jnana Diptihi. Jnana means the knowledge. Okay. Knowledge will become uplifted. Dipti means uplifted. Okay. What is the dipti means? The shininess of the knowledge. Means what is telling here? If the Ashuddhi was there or what is there inside the chitta in the stages, three stages, shipta, mura and vikshipta. If it is decreased means automatically the knowledge will become sufficient or increasement will be there. Up to here. Okay, here knowledge means the chitta related knowledge, the self knowledge. Up to here, up to avivaka khyate he a. See, this is not a. Avivaka khyate means until vivaka khyate. Okay, for example, here knowledge is increasing, but here vivaka khyati is there. Okay, vivaka khyati. So it will reach to up to this state. If you practice yoga angas, the knowledge will come. Then Jnanaditya will be there up to the Vivaka Khyate. Beyond it won't go. Because the practice benefits is this much only. So you should be very clear with your mind. So two benefits of Yoga Angas, Abhyasa. Anushthana means practicing. Here Anushthana means practicing. Okay. So practicing of Yoga Anga. What are the Yoga Anga? We will be discussing the next video. I mean in the next part. So what is telling here? Yoga Anga. The limbs of yoga, if you practice yoga, if you practice, what will happen? Anushthana means practice. Ashuddhi. The ashuddhi means the impurity or the malinya. What is malinya is there in the chitta, mainly in the first three stages. Shiptam, mura, viksham, vikshiptam. In these three stages, if you have the any impurities, that can be clean up. Okay, that's called the ashuddhi shaya. So if the ashuddhi is decreased or become zero, shaya, decreasement, then automatically the knowledge will become more and more uplifted. Knowledge of self that you are practicing. Up to here, that is avivaka khyati, until vivaka khyati. And last class we already discussed what is vivaka khyati and their seven stages, saptabhumi, discuss also. So here vivaka khyati means, remember vivaka khyati stands for the difference between the purusha and prakriti. ओके डिफरेंस नॉलेज बिटवीन दिस टू दैट्स ऑल. पुरुष इज डिफरेंट प्रकृति इज डिफरेंट दैट इज कॉल्ड द विवेक ख्याति विशेष ख्याति विवेक ख्याति ख्याति मीन्स नॉलेज विशेष नॉलेज स्पेशल नॉलेज कॉल विवेक ख्याति. तो स्पेशल नॉलेज बिटवीन द पुरुष प्रकृति आत्मा अनात्मा ओके फॉल्स नॉलेज एंड राइट नॉलेज दिस इज कॉल्ड विवेक ख्याति. सो अप टू देयर इट्स कॉल्ड एज द बेनिफिट ऑफ योगांगा विल सस्टेन. सो दिस इज द मीनिंग ऑफ दिस पर्टिकुलर सूत्र. सो प्लीज कीप इन माइंड ऑल दिस लाइन. सो लेट्स सी नेक्स्ट वन. ओके एंड आई ऑलरेडी मेंशन दिस योगांगा प्रैक्टिसिंग ओनली ओनली फॉर द जनरल प्रैक्टिस रिमेंबर. ओके मीन्स दिस इज कॉल्ड उपाय प्रत्यय. Those who are related to Upaya Pratyaya means in this birth, first time they are practicing. For them, this will start with Yoga Angas. And for others, this is called the Bhava Pratyaya, Abhyasa Vairagya and all. Already mentioned in the first chapter. So let's see the next sutra. Now, see the next sutra is telling here, what are the Yoga Angas? And we need to understand those Yoga Angas. The line is telling here, Yama Niyama Asana Pranayama Pratyahara Dharana Dhyana Samadhi Ashtavyangani Iti. If you split the line, it will become Yama, Niyama, Asana, Pranayama, Pratyahara, Dharana, Dhyana, Samadhyo, Ashta, Eva, Angani. So Yama will become 1, Niyama 2, Asana 3, Pranayama 4th, Pratyahara 5th, Dharana is 6, Dhyana is 7 and Samadhi is 8. So our aim is Ashta. See, Ashta means 8. This is the 8. Okay. So how many limbs are there according to Patanjali Yoga Sutra? If the question asks, the answer should be Ashtanga, 8 angas. And we will be looking little deeply inside that. Okay, 8 limbs are there. Now for your understanding, I am telling here in the Yoga Sutra itself, this first 5 First five means Yama, Niyama, Asana, Pranayama, Pratyahara. They are known as the external practice. External means Bahya. Remember, Bahyanga. Okay. And remaining three, these three, Dharana, Dhyana, Samadhi, they called as the internal. Means Antaranga. Okay. Internal practice. Later on, some other differences here will be talking as sutra comes. Now you understand here. The Yama stands for Yama meaning means the control. Control on self. Okay, self-control. You should have the control over you. Okay. And Yama is known as the universal discipline. Okay. Universal discipline. Anyone can follow at any time. We'll be talking later on also, but I'm talking the telling the name only now. Okay. And Niyama is the individual. Individual discipline. Okay. It may be followed by you, it may not be followed by some other persons. Okay. And Asana meaning we know the posture. Pranayama also we know the breathing technique. Okay. Pratyahara also we know the control the sensory organs. Okay, I'm writing in short form. And dharana means you should know the concentrations. And dhyana stands for the meditations. I'll be talking later, just what meaning here now. Okay. And samadhi means the higher state of mind. Higher state of mind, or you can write here chitta. Okay. So there are 8 limbs, Ashtava Angani. Okay. Yes. So next topic we'll be talking in the next class. Thank you very much. Like, comment, share and subscribe. Bye.